Hey guys, LParker77 here and welcome back to another Inform Silver player review. Today's player review is going to be of Inform Diabaté, the Mali striker that plays for Bordeaux in the French League One. He's a very, very nice, cheap striker, as because of the team this season, he's actually very, very cheap. Very similar to the man of the match last season in terms of stats. This year, I think he's going for about 15 to 20k, so it's nice and cheap. In terms of the team I've been using him in this French League One squad, 4-3-3, playing up there as the lone striker. We can take a look at his stats now. And on the card, he's got 66 pace, 72 dribbling, 79 shooting, and 82 heading. So he's a real target man, to be honest. In terms of his other stats, he is 6'4". He is right-footed with medium work rates and 2-star skill moves and 2-star weak foot. And then in terms of his in-game stats, his best stats really, I'm going to talk about a few of them. He's in terms of physical stats, he's got 71 sprint speed with 59 acceleration. So acceleration a lot lower than sprint speed. Also with 91 strength. Mental attributes, they're pretty good. 76 aggression and 77 attacking positioning. And the best skill attributes there are 92 finishing, 82 heading accuracy, 90 shot power and 82 volleys. So I can show you the gameplay now and talk about how he performed in game, how he was. And first thing I'm going to have to say, he's a must buy for any French League One silver squad. Easily the best French League One silver striker. In terms of most of the strikers in the league, I didn't really like many of them, but Inform Diabaté, he is a real, real gem. He's well worth trying out. He's been kind of overlooked because of all the team this season silver, so now only goes for about 15 to 20k. And considering he has fairly solid stats and very similar stats to the man of the match last year that went for about sort of 300, 400k, he's well worth picking up. A lot of people won't use him because obviously on the card he's only got 66 pace and that's not great with the 2-star skill moves and 2-star weak foot, but honestly he does feel a lot faster. As I mentioned in the in-game stats, he's got about 59 acceleration, which does mean his sprint speed is much higher, about 71. Obviously his acceleration is very, very poor, but the pace is bearable and I didn't really notice it too much. Obviously did get caught up a few times by faster defenders. Most of the time his power did actually help, and when he went through on goal he did usually manage to get the shot away. So obviously his strength and his power is really, really noticeable. I think it was around 91 strength and he's very, very strong. Not as strong as someone like Team this season Wook with a 99 strength, but still very, very strong. Also 82 heading, 6'4" as well. He won pretty much most headers, to be honest. And also, he's actually got fairly good jumping. Unlike Team This Season Work, Team This Season Work is 6'5" with good heading. So wins most of the headers because he's tall and has fairly poor jumping. Diabaté is 6'4" with 82 heading on the card, but also actually has really good jumping, so that really, really helps. In terms of his shooting, he is a really excellent finisher. He always seems like he's in the right place at the right time. That's helped a lot by 85 reactions, something I did actually notice a lot in game, as well as his fairly high attacking positioning, about 77. Something I did notice, he did score a lot of rebounds, which I know every striker can score rebounds, but he was always in the right place at the right time. And considering his pace, he did keep up with the play, and even with my fast wingers like Briand and Sacco getting shots away, I think it was actually the Mali left wing I actually used. He's even faster than Sacco. They did manage to get shots away, and if he did rebound off the keeper, Diabaté would always finish it. So yeah, he's pretty much a really great poacher. When it comes to his power shots and his long shots, they are pretty good. He does have fairly inconsistent long shots, so one match I'd be able to score some nice long shots with him, or they go on target. Other matches, a bit like someone like Team of the Season Work, they would just go completely off target. So as I said, his long shots are a bit inconsistent. But when it comes to his power shots, he's got an incredibly powerful shot, and to be honest, most of the time it will go on target and probably will actually go in. And lastly, before I go on to my overall thoughts, he also only has 2-star skill moves and 2-star weak foot, so his left foot is pretty awful, to be honest. And also the 2-star skill moves aren't great considering his dribbling is only 72. I would say his dribbling was actually okay though, it was bearable along with his pace. So on to my overall thoughts, he does have fairly good dribbling, although dribbling on the card is only 72. I didn't really have many problems with that. He's also very strong with the 91 strength. He's an excellent finisher. He wins most headers because he's tall and also has good jumping as well. He's got an incredibly powerful shot. He is also incredibly cheap for his stats. 79 shooting, 72 dribbling and 82 heading. Incredibly good stats on the card considering he's only 15 to 20k. He's also got 85 reactions and I think it's about 77 attacking positioning as well. And so those stats are noticeable in game, and he's a great poacher, always getting onto rebounds. In terms of a couple of negatives, he has fairly inconsistent long shots. His pace was bearable, but acceleration was incredibly, incredibly poor. He also only has the 2-star skill moves and 2-star weak foot. Lastly, we'll move on to the final rating, and I'm going to give him an 8 out of 10. He was incredibly fun to use. His pace didn't let me down at all. I still managed to score about 13 goals and I think about 6 games with him, so that's not too bad really for a striker with that sort of pace, considering everyone pretty much makes pace teams nowadays. And people always ask, and I do like to include this at the end of my reviews, is he worth it? Would I say he's worth picking up? Yes, definitely. 15 to 20k is very, very cheap for a striker like the Inform Diabaté. So there we go, guys. That is it for my Inform Diabaté player review. I thought I'd change it up a bit and do a few informed player reviews from this week and then focus on more of the team of season players. So if you've enjoyed this video, please feel free to give this a like, and the next review is probably going to be informed Dicko before I then move on to a few more of the team of seasons. So thanks for watching, guys. Cheers.